Welcome to part C of practical number 6, that is servomotor control using Arduino. So in the part B, we have seen the connection diagram to connect the servomotor to Arduino. So according to our discussion, that is the three pins that needs to be connected will be control signal, then supply voltage and the ground. So this control signal must be your PWM signal. So why we need to connect here PWM, that also we have discussed in our previous session. So here the connection diagram is drawn accordingly, because 9 pin of Arduino Uno is going to provide us PWM wave at 50 Hz frequency. Okay, that means after every 20 millisecond the pulse will be there. So for stepper motor also, for servo motor also, you will require to have that is pulse after every 20 millisecond to, that is, remain motor in its 0° position, that is in initial position. Now varying the duty cycle from 1 millisecond to 2 millisecond, you can control the position of the servo motor from 0° to 180°. Okay, so for 1.5 millisecond of T on period, you can have the servo motor can be rotated by 90°. So pulse of duration 2 millisecond means 2 millisecond on and other 18 millisecond off. So accordingly you can have the duty cycle and you can rotate the servo motor to 180°. Okay, so from 0 position to 180°. So to have the different angles from 0 to 180°, you need to provide the pulses from duration of T on, which is changing from 1 millisecond to 2 milliseconds. So that's the strategy that is going to be used. So this is nothing but the configuration. Now the same configuration, for the same configuration we will make a program in Arduino IDE. So here, as Arduino, in this Arduino IDE, you can say that here our peripheral is servo motor. Now to actually controlling a servo motor using other controller is quite a difficult task, but Arduino IDE made that easy for us, because Arduino has developed some set of libraries for us for different peripherals. So you must tell Arduino IDE that you are going to use that library into your program. So similar to servo motor, there is a other library of, that is, you can say LCD, which is another peripheral. The another peripheral to Arduino is going to have, you can have the different types of sensors also. So for different sensors also, the Arduino IDE has developed the library. And that is the very important thing, that Arduino is nowadays going to be used in almost all the, that is, applications, because easy going set of libraries are available with you. So the thing is to access those library or to include those library into your program and use in according to the your application, use the commands to extract the things from that library. So no need to program on your own. So you just need to use those library commands, and that's the beauty. So here the first command in this program tells Arduino IDE that you are going to use servo.h library of Arduino IDE, because here our aim is to control servo motor. So hash include servo.h is going to tell Arduino IDE that you are going to use servo library of Arduino IDE. If you don't include this as your first statement, then you cannot use the servo commands related in Arduino IDE into your program. So this is very, that is, it's mandatory task to include the library if you are going to use the functions from that particular library. Then what is next statement? So here you are going to use servo as a library. So here my servo is nothing but the object. So my servo is nothing but I have created the object for my servo motor. So here, similar to this, you can create different objects. Suppose if I am going to use two servo motors, how the statement is going to be changed? Servo, my servo 1. The second statement will be servo, my servo 2. In that case, I am going to use two servo motors. So in a similar way, you can connect at a time, you can connect 8 servo motors with the help of this Arduino. So in that case, I am having 8 statement, that is servo, my servo 1. Second statement will be servo, my servo 2, up to servo, my servo 8. So I have created 8 objects. So the servo motor 1 is going to be represented by my servo 1 in that case, and servo motor number 8 is going to be represented by my servo 8 if I am going to use 8 such servo motors. But in this example, we are going to use only one servo motor, so I have created only one object, but you can create many such. Okay, so again, this is nothing but that statement. So here position equal to 0, because we are going to move the motor, servo motor, with different angles going from 0 to 180 degree. So the I need to declare one variable, that is position, which is obviously integer, to store the servo positions at globally. Then in a setup, as discussed earlier, I need to define the connections. So what is the connection here? The connection in the sense how where you have connected the peripheral to the Arduino. So here, as the diagram, in the diagram, we have already discussed, that is Arduino pin number 9 of Arduino is going to be connected to control pin of servo. So that's the only connection. So the same needs to be told to the Arduino through Arduino ID. So here now you can see, that is attach, write, like functions, at detach. These are nothing but available from servo.h library. You will get set up all these functions from your Arduino basic website. Okay, so you will come to know these set up functions, because the Arduino itself is going to upgrade these functions day by day. So if you want to make yourself updated, that is, try to visit such kind of websites regularly so that you can come to know the functions available in that. Okay, so here the attach function is nothing but, obviously, it attaches the servo motor to corresponding pin. So my servo is nothing but my servo name, that is nothing but my motor I have named with the object my servo. So my servo dot attach 9 attaches the servo motor to pin number 9 of Arduino. So this is nothing but the setup that I have created, and I have, through this set statement, I have told Arduino ID that at pin number 9 the control signal of my servo motor 1 is connected. So every statement you should elaborate in your own way. Okay, so don't mug up the programming. Make a practice that through understanding you should able to write this programming, because it's easy task once you understand the basic thing behind that, because we have done with setup. Now as stated in earlier sessions also, in the loop you need to define the functionality. So what is the functionality here? The functionality is you are going to rotate the motor connected at pin number 9 of Arduino Uno from 0 to 180 degree. Here our basic aim is to rotate motor from 0 to 180 degree. So as discussed earlier, theoretically you should provide 1 millisecond to 2 millisecond pulses at this pin. That means this mine number pin should change the duty cycles, or other way to do that is by directly using write function available from servo.h library. So here my servo is nothing but my servo number 1, because this is nothing but name of my servo. Write position. So position, which position? From 0 to 180 degree. So regarding for loop also, we have to write for loop, we have discussed in previous session. That is here initial condition, final position, and then increment. That is nothing but for position equal to 0 up to 180 degree, increment that with value of 1. So in a step of 1 degree, the servo motor is going to be returned with value. So this is the way you can access the inbuilt commands present with servo.h library. So here we have learned two commands, attach, which is going to attach the motor to particular pin. Then here dot write. So here dot is nothing but accessor. So my servo dot write is going to write position determined by this loop on the servo motor. That is nothing but at pin number 9. So intentionally the delay of 15 is going to be kept so as to understand the operation. Okay. So similarly again here the second loop indicates that is from 180 to again back to 0 position with decrement by factor of 1. So with 1 degree of decrement the motor will bring to 0 position again. So my servo dot write position. So this second loop corresponds to going from 180 degree to 0 degree. This loop corresponds to 0 to 180 degree. So here that's all. So here we have learned two command. That is nothing but we have learned how to use the library present in Arduino IDE. Here I am not telling that servo.h is the only library. For example, suppose you are going to use, let us say, a fire sensor with Arduino IDE. So fire sensor library is available in Arduino IDE. You need to search for that and you need to include that. Okay. And then related with that, you are having the functions available in the library similar to the servo. So for servo, we have learned two functions, attach, right. Similarly, you can have detach function also. So detachment, it is not going to consider. It is reverse of attach. So it's nothing but like the course is not limited with these practicals. You should able to update these things because right now you are in first year. So up to that is in third year level, you are going to develop some projects, mini projects. So as you are from different disciplines, so you can make use of those concepts into your projects to automate the process. So don't limit the study of this lab for this semester only. Try to upgrade yourself with this knowledge by regularly visiting the websites of Arduino. Because nowadays there are, that is, it is updating or upgrading in very fast way. Okay, so that you will be in touch with this subject. And I am saying it's very important to study this subject. You will get the significance of that in your third year. Because in that you are going to handle some mini project kind of things. Okay. So now coming back to our program, I am going to verify the code. So here it's going to say me that done compiling. Now similar with our other sessions, here I have created the Proteus simulation for it. So in Proteus here, obviously Arduino is there. And if you see at pin number 9, this is nothing but servo motor. So servo motor is available in Arduino. So I have taken the servo motor. So how to take that? We have already discussed. From the pick menu, you are going to type servo motor. The servo motor will appear. I have given supply voltage of 5 voltage. One end is grounded and one end is connected to 9. So the similar configuration that we have discussed over here is drawn in the Proteus. So I am going to upload the code. That is hex file for that code. Yeah, as our regular procedure. So here I am going to get the hex file of my code. You can see. I am going to copy this now. And I am going to paste it over here. So paste, then OK. So now this setup is going to work with the program of rotating the stepper, rotating the servo motor from 0 to 180 degree and from 180 degree to back to 0. So now I am going to run the simulation. So if I run the simulation, you can see how the motor is able to rotate from 0 to 180 degree. And other like that. So again, it is going to be because we have kept delay of 15. So that's all.